there. We covered up to saying that there is no third person in the family of God. There is only two, the Father and the Son. The Father is Spirit, Holy Spirit. The book of John, chapter 4, verse 24. Yeshua said it. The essence of God is Spirit, is a spirit being. He is holy. That's His character. So we have the Holy Spirit being the divine nature of Elohim. The divine nature of Almighty God is Holy Spirit. And Yeshua, when He was resurrected by the Father, by His Holy Spirit, meaning He Himself, the Father Himself, being the Spirit, He rose up as the life-giving Spirit, Holy Spirit. What is born of the Spirit is Spirit, Yeshua said. Now, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 45, it says, the second man is the life-giving Spirit. The Bible says there are no two spirits. Father is Spirit, the Son is Spirit, but one Spirit, one Holy Spirit. The Father is in the Son, and the Son is in the Father. As you find in John 14:11. Do you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? First he said, believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. Yeshua said, the Father's Spirit is the Holy Spirit. Matthew 10:20, chapter 10, verse 20. For it will not be you speaking, but the Spirit of your Father speaking through you. The Spirit of your Father is the Holy Spirit. God is holy and He is Spirit, He is the Holy Spirit. Mark chapter 13, verse 11. When they arrest you and hand you over, do not worry beforehand about what you are to say, but say whatever is given to you in that very hour. For it is not you who speak, but it is the Holy Spirit. Mark records it this way. Matthew recorded it, is the Spirit of your Father. It's just the same. It takes actually humbleness and a desire to learn, unlearn the lies and to learn the truth. Yeshua said, those who love the truth will listen to my voice. He who is of the truth listens to me." He said this while talking to Pilate during his trial. And Luke chapter 12 verse 12 also say that the Holy Spirit will speak through them. And again, Luke chapter 21 verse 15, it says, "Don't be worried about what you're going to say. Well, I will give you an utterance and wisdom which none of your opponents will be able to resist or refute." Who's going to give the utterance? Who's going to give the words? Yeshua himself. "I will give you." The Father and the Son. The Son says now in this scripture that he is going to give the words. Now, we are called to partake of the Holy Spirit. Partaking of the Holy Spirit is what? What is the meaning of that? Hebrews chapter 6, verse 4. "For in the case of those who have once been enlightened and have been made partakers of the Holy Spirit." Partakers of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, we establish that's the Father and the Son. The divine nature of the Father and the Son. The Father is holy. The Son is holy. The Father is Spirit. The Son is Spirit. We have no two spirits, the Bible says. We have one Spirit, the Father and the Son, with whom we are called for fellowship. 1 John chapter 1 verse 3. Fellowshipping with the Father and the Son is our calling. Not with a spirit title name, just Holy Spirit, a different third entity. No, that's not there in the Bible. That's a demonic doctrine of Trinity. I know not everyone who is going to receive this. Absolutely no. Those who desire for truth, those who want to unlearn whatever that they have learned as truth, not knowing it was a lie, dying and going to heaven, is being preached and taught until this very day by the West. So, what is meant by partaking of the Holy Spirit? We just now said Holy Spirit is the divine nature of the Father and the Son. One Spirit. It's their divine nature. They are holy, they are spirits. One Spirit. Let's go to 2 Peter. Chapter 1, verse 4. "For by this he has granted to us his precious and magnificent promises, so that by them you may become partakers of the divine nature." There you find. Partaking of the Holy Spirit, The Father and the Son is partakers of the divine nature. Their nature is holy and their spirit. When the divine nature will be fulfilled totally, consummation will be on the day of resurrection, when the believers who slept in the Lord, believed His coming kingdom, those people who take part in the first resurrection, they will be raised as spirits, just like Yeshua. We are not a spirit being now. The nature of humanity is sinful flesh. God is Holy Spirit. That's why God said in Genesis chapter 6, "My spirit shall not strive with man forever, for he is also flesh." What is born of the spirit is spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh. So this is another doctrine of error to teach people that man is a spirit being now. If he is a spirit being now, he will be immortal, like Elohim, like Almighty God. So partakers of the Holy Spirit, those people who have been promised, for those believers who are obedient to the commandments that were given by Yeshua the Messiah, by the Father, they are promised with the indwelling of the Father and the Son, with whom we are called for fellowship. John said, that is the apostolic faith. Where is Christianity? They have made a spirit and called it Holy Spirit, where there is no name, and they have fellowship with that spirit, not with the Father and the Son. The third entity that was discovered or invented in Nicaea 325 AD has no name. Dangerous. So until this very day, Christianity has held on to this doctrine of Trinity, which is not in the Bible. Yeshua never preached it or taught. The apostles never mentioned anything about this, the Trinity. And those who heard from the apostles, never. They held on to the original faith that was once delivered to the apostles. But Christianity has gone on its own way. Those who have ears, let them hear. So Peter said, to take part in the divine nature, 2 Peter 1:4, and Paul says in Hebrews chapter 6 verse 4, is to partake of the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit is the Father and the Son. God bless you.